Welcome to Recharge with Richardson, 5 minutes of hope and inspiration every Monday and Thursday. And now, here is today's episode. Well, good morning to everybody on this wonderful Tuesday. I owe you all an apology. I was away on a camping trip with my family this past weekend and wasn't able to get the Monday recharge episode ready for you. So my bad, my apologies, but here it is for Tuesday. I've entitled my thoughts today, God Wants the Best for You. And I'm excited about the next few episodes I'm going to share with you because I think they can really do some positive things for each one of us in our lives. The scripture I want to start with is from 3 John verse 2, where the Bible says, "Beloved, I pray that you may prosper in all things and be in health, just as your soul prospers." God absolutely wants us to live life to its fullest. That's what I hear him saying in this verse. It's about inspiring us to make progress, to be all that God created you to be, and to unleash your potential, to have a life of purpose and to live with passion. God wants the best for us. That's what he just told us in his word. And he intends for us to be prosperous and healthy. I'm not making that up. Those are his own words. But what happened was a usurper came, as you know, the devil in the Garden of Eden, stole that life away from us. And we became slaves of the devil's destructive way of life. And another way to look at it is you could say that he actually took our freedom of choice away from us. When we bought into his lie, it doomed us, put us on a one-way road to destruction. No choice, death. But God intervened to give us back that choice. And that's what I love about what he says in John chapter 10, verse 10, because that's one of the reasons that Jesus came. And that's what it says right here. John 10, 10, the thief does not come to steal except, sorry, let me start again. The thief does not come except to steal and to kill and to destroy. Jesus talking says, but I have come that they may have life and that they may have it more abundantly. And so the devil is the one whose goal and whose plan is to steal and kill and destroy us. But Jesus came to give us an abundant life. Jesus came, God sent him, so that actually, when you think about it, as the devil took away our freedom of choice, Jesus came to restore that freedom of choice. His death on Calvary's cross, his payment for your sin and my sin, actually opens the door back up to giving us a choice in the matter. We're freed from that slavery. And so now we are restored to freedom to choose to enter into that abundant life that God wants for us to have. And so I really want to highlight that making good choices is the key to living the life that God wants you to live. And so before we can make any positive changes, we really have to make some deliberate choices to do so. And so I want to share with you today quickly three simple lessons about choices that I hope you'll keep in mind. And then we'll explore this in a little more detail in the next couple episodes. So the first thing that I want to share with you about choices is this. Choices are like seeds. The harvest is not immediate. You know, today, in today's world, we expect instant gratification. We're just used to it. You know, instant coffee and drive-through fast food restaurants and instant popcorn. I mean, you name it. It's ready. You can have it at a moment's notice. And we're used to that. And we kind of have come to expect that. But and so when it comes to changing our lives, we often think that, man, you know, what's the silver bullet that I can just instantly have this great life that I'm dreaming of? But I want you to understand that having that kind of life, the abundant life that God wants for you, it's not just an instant process. Just like when you plant a seed, it takes time for that seed to germinate and to grow and then to bear its harvest and its fruit. The same thing with our choices. When we begin making good choices, it's like planting that seed. We don't get results immediately. They will come, but they will take time. And as you keep making those good choices, then that good result is going to come. And so we've got to be willing to wait for good results to come in our life. Second of all, bad choices cancel good ones. Let's say I decide to eat a salad for supper, and I enjoy it, and it's great. It's really a healthy salad. I'm feeling good, and I'm so proud of myself that I decide to celebrate with an extra large banana split loaded with vanilla ice cream and drowned in chocolate fudge and caramel and sprinkled with Skittles or gummy bears or something like that or whatever. Friends, if I do that, I've just canceled out any good that that salad might have done for me. And last thing that I want to share with you today is good choices taken to extremes can actually become bad. There's balance that's important. For example, drinking enough water it's very important for the optimal functioning of our bodies and our health and all those good things. But if you get too much water, or if I get too much water, it's called drowning, right? We could actually die. If I you know, get too much water, I'm going to die. And so balance is so important in the area of choice. And so what I want to leave you with today is this. Don't forget, we are what we choose. And then remember, no matter what you're going through in your life, God's got this, and God's got you. Thank you for joining us for Recharge with Richardson. Don't forget to join us for our next episode, and until then, may God fill you with joy and peace and hope.